Come in!
Ah, Dr. Beth.
Hello, Puglington.
Hello. I'm wondering if you can help.
Of course.
I seem to have a rash on my leg.
Oh, and what would you like me to do about it?
Well, you're Dr. Beth.
I am Dr. Beth Perry, yes, but I'm not that kind of a doctor.
Oh?
I'm an academic doctor, a doctor of words.
Ah, I see.
I talk and think a lot here at the University of Salford.
Right. On my form that Manfred gave me, it does say surf.
Yes.
Can I see your wetsuit?
No, I work at a university. Surf is our research centre at the University of Salford.
Ah, see. Now, what exactly does that entail?
Well, we
did
do...
Did you see a tail?
A tail?
Did you like that?
I did. I like that. And you've got a lovely tail, haven't you? So let me tell you a tale about Ideas for Odsall. Ideas for Odsall is a research project funded by the Arts and Humanities Research Council Connected Communities Programme. And it's taking place in Odsall, your own neighbourhood.
Oh.
We are putting decision making about local cultural and creative activities into the hands of local people. So we're supporting 20 of your friends and neighbours to give their own ideas a boost so that they can develop activities that they want to see happening locally. There's everything from local history plays to a community festival to an art collective. And I'll tell you what, Puglington, why don't you go and find out what everyone has been doing?
I shall go now.
Oh, what a lovely dog.
Friend Ross, who is organising site workshops. Hello, Ross.
Hello, Paddington.
Could you tell the viewers what inspired you to do your project?
Well, I'm a keen cyclist, and I wanted to show the people of Odsall who also like cycling how to look after and maintain their bicycles through a series of bike workshops.
And how have the workshops been received?
They've been received well. Although most people have just turned up with old bikes wanting them to be fixed. So the workshops are slightly adapted now, so we've now got a bike mechanic who comes down and helps tinker and fix bikes. And I've got a volunteer as well, Simon, who helps and we just show people how to maintain and look after the bikes and make sure that they're safe to ride. Tyres pumped up, brakes working, gears, chains all oiled up. It's going really well.
I then went to see my friends from DIY Theatre at the Angel Centre. They've been learning how to film and edit A Day in the Life of the Angel Centre, a film which you can see at the Islington Mill Festival. They start each session with a set of warm-up exercises which look like a lot of fun. My favourite was Pat the Puglington.
Is he cuddling? That's a good question. Cuddling?
Yes.
Stay back there and ask him the question again. Oh, you
got it. Drop a picture
like that.
On my way back, I met up with Laura at OCA, where she was choosing designs for her notice board. The notice board is to be used to inform the local community of events in Odsall. Helping Laura with her board design was local artist Marie. I was also very helpful choosing my favourite designs. The board's great unveiling was a community event with food and refreshments and singing and dancing.
Oh, 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 oh. research project led by Salford University, Laura came up with the idea of having a community billboard.
Local councillor Tanya Birch helped Laura cut the ribbon. All in all, it was a great success. I then went to hang out with David Lowther, a local artist who is giving people the chance to commit their memories to fabrics. These fabrics will then be displayed on a washing line around Ordsall. I was inspired to make my own. David has been displaying his arts around Ordsall ever since. I then had to be at Ordsall Community Allotments to see Marie.
My ideas for Ordsall is to introduce bees onto the allotment so we can produce some Salford honey and educate children and adults about why we need bees. But we haven't even got any bees yet.
While I was there, I was attacked by a swarm of killer bees. Thankfully, I managed to fight them off. Marie did a beekeeping course where she learned how to pull faces at her bees. I then had an important date with Rosemary Swift. That date was 1911.
I'm Rosemary Swift. I met Jess from the university and her cohort Amber, who works in the community of Ordsall and for Salford Lads Club, who told me about a project called Ideas for Ordsall. And I've always been interested in the fact that this very barracks estate site was an infantry barracks, and it made me decide to research the history of the infantry barracks and then carry it through to the modern day. And a theatre group today, the 20th of June 2015, as part of my submission to the Ideas for Ordsall project, are enacting scenes from the infantry barracks days. And then in certain houses on this estate, as if at the 1911 census. Some really gruesome tales come out of the barracks, but the one that's took my heart is an artist dying there at the age of 32, and this puzzled me, but it led me to see that he was actually a soldier and he'd come from the south of the country to go to Australia, had some family, took his wife and children to India, had some more family, was then stationed here at Salford and died at the age of 32. And yet his work that's now in West Perth Museum is outstanding. It's like early Picasso. And I feel how sad that his life was cut short.
I was then asked to model for Becky. Thankfully not in my birthday suit. Becky's assistant, Mason, was a cheeky little monkey. He got on extremely well with Manfred. I'm sure you'll all agree, Becky's made me look extra handsome. To the Ordsall Festival, where she took pictures of the local wildlife. Strangely, her booth was much bigger on the inside. I then went to see the table dancers of Ordsall. Actually, I was there at Salford Lads Club to see Chef Ray, who has been teaching the girls' club how to prepare and serve a three-course meal. humans in the shower cap started by cutting up elephants. Managed to get myself a rather large doggy bag. I then had a pressing engagement with Steph. She was waiting for her printing press to be delivered, and what a handsome machine it was. It took two strong men to move it. I couldn't help because I'm a dog. The press will be used by the local community. And what a smooth action it has. Steph helped me to produce my new business card. As you can see, I'm in fashion. I needed somewhere to display it, so I decided to have a trip down to Salford Quays. While there, I visited the Lowry Outlet and the Oddsall Art Collective. I was given a very warm welcome by the staff and had a little chat. I was then shown around some of the art. I'm sure you'll agree, there is something for everyone.
Yes, that's art, Chef. More art, please? Yes. Yes, I know this place. Yes, I know all of these. Yes, I've seen all of these before. Hello. They're not very friendly. Some of the nibbles they had on display were delicious, I must say. Especially the little biscuits they had in the dog bowl.
Hello,
I'm here for the art. I don't think we understand. I don't think we understand my question. I'm convinced he's a lunatic. Hello, I am here for the art. Yes, he's definitely a
We then all met up for a road trip to Birmingham. I entertained everybody with my marvellous singing. I'm classically trained, don't you know, by Barbara Woodhouse. We then took a trip to Tolkien's birthplace, to Middle Earth. I was a little disappointed as we didn't find any hobbits. However, we did stop to have coffee to warm up because winter is coming.
As a child, Tolkien lived on Wake Green Road, which is the road we're going to head up to, just along. So he played around here as a child, and whether it's apocryphal or not, there's plenty of evidence to suggest that these are the kind of inspiration for the mills and the places from when he played as a child.
Very tiring finding all these sticks these humans keep losing. Once I found all these sticks, it was time for us to head off back home. Because it was time for the Islington Community Festival. There was lots of activities going on. People were exhibiting their goods and selling things. We had a mad scientist, which was great fun. I liked all the pretty colours. They were smashing. We even had little humans having their faces painted to look like butterflies. Whoa! Had a little walk around. Look at me, I'm brilliant, yes. I decided I'd like to make a badge. There were things being given away, like these that Ross had. I think you'll agree, this rather does suit me. I decided I needed to do some warm-up exercises. And I even had time for a spot of ballet. As you can see, I'm very good at it. Then I met up with Mike. Mike's from the St. Philip's Camera Club. He was there with his club, taking pictures of all the local people attending the festival. Of course, I couldn't disappoint my fans. I then had another sniff about to see what else was happening, and that was very whiffy actually. I shan't do that again. Ross tried to give me a hat, but I pointed out I already had one until it fell off. And here's one of my fans, and she's a fan, yes, she's definitely a fan. And there's another one of my fans, I have lots of fans actually. And finally, here are some of the other projects funded by Ideas for Oddsall.